My name is Scott Thompson. I'm a professor in the physiology department, and I am a neuroscientist. I mentor students through the graduate program in life sciences, primarily in the neuroscience track, also students in the molecular medicine track. So in my laboratory, there's really several sets of projects we're interested in. We're interested in the normal ability of the brain to change, which we call plasticity. That is absolutely the underpinnings of the functions of learning, memory formation, memory consolidation. The other big aspect of research in my lab is what happens in the brain in response to injury. Our working hypothesis here is that in many forms of injury, some of the negative consequences, and in particular we focus on post-traumatic epilepsy and also pain after spinal cord injury, and our working hypothesis is that in the brain's attempt to heal itself, it uses some of these plastic mechanisms that are important to it for learning and memory and normally, and uses those same sorts of processes in an attempt to heal itself. We think what happens is that the brain is doing the best it can to heal itself, but something goes wrong. Things, unpredicted consequences come out for that healing response. And those plastic changes then underlie the pathology of post-traumatic epilepsy, pain after spinal cord injury. In particular, in our studies of pain after spinal cord injury, we hypothesized that there were changes in the thalamus, which is usually called the train station of the brain. The information from the peripheral, from the skin, from the muscles, from the joints, is funneled to the brain through this thalamic structure. One of the beauties of the hypothesis we made, and in fact confirmed, was that an existing drug that's actually used to treat childhood absence epilepsy, which is a disease of excessive thalamic discharge, we predicted would work in this pain syndrome if, in fact, our hypothesis was true. And so we tested ethosuximide. Ethosuximide is the name of the drug that's used for treating childhood absence epilepsy. We tested this drug in our rat model and found that it was absolutely a silver bullet. So this is really exciting for us to think that we could maybe offer a new treatment for pain after spinal cord injury based on an existing medication. So that is the most favorable situation you could hope. Here's a drug that's been around for 40, 50 years, perfectly safe, perfectly effective. Maybe we can just repurpose it and use it not for childhood absence epilepsy, but for treating pain after spinal cord injury. I've been very fortunate to have a number of fantastically talented and motivated graduate students and postgraduate students in the laboratory that really are the hands that do the work. And not only the hands that do the work, but also the brains that contribute the ideas. And really all of the work that goes on in my lab is a great collaborative effort between the students and myself and the fellows and myself. And you think you know where you're going in a set of experiments, and it's really not until you start down that road that you begin to see doors opening up, new opportunities to follow leads, formulate hypotheses, design new experiments. And really the most exciting aspect of being a professor is to have that interaction with the students and to have that interaction powering discovery.